Well, it's the 31st of July 2014, and it's really good to have you two sitting here. Would you just like to tell us who you are and where you're from?
Yeah, that's fine. My name's Ian. I'm from Thetford, in Norfolk.
And I'm Kelly.
Hi, Kelly. Good to see you both here. And I gather you came to Ffald-Y-Brenin yesterday.
We actually came the day before. So we've been here 2 days.
Oh, okay.
But a beautiful place.
And you were camping fairly locally?
Yes, we were.
Yeah. So what happened when you came up for morning prayers yesterday morning?
Well, we missed morning prayers. And we went and sat at the cross all day long among the sun. and just spent time up there all day. I listened to the grace outpouring on my phone. Ian listened to some music.
How much of the grace outpouring did you listen to on your phone?
The whole lot. it was just amazing. And then we went into the chapel just before we went into evening prayer.
Okay. Now you're holding something in your hand there. Can you just explain what it is?
This is my guide stick. I don't know what you'd call it actually. A white blind stick to help to see where I'm going, basically to feel things in front of me.
Because you suffered from a disease that was found when you were very young, I think.
Yes, I did, yeah. I was 2½.
What's the disease called?
Toxoplasmosis.
And how did that affect you?
It affected me quite a lot because I couldn't do normal things. I couldn't go cycling and things like that. Just as I got my family and things like that, it got a bit more difficult.
And then 10 years ago, what happened?
It was 8 years ago, sorry.
8 years ago.
I just woke up one morning and turned around and said to my husband that I couldn't see and he thought I was mucking around, basically. had a lot of hospital appointments and things like that. Spent the whole day by myself up there. But there was nothing they could really do. They didn't really understand what was going on, really. Basically, I had to restart my life again, really, and it affected not just me, it affected everybody.
And you have children?
I have 7 children, plus extras that we look after.
So, have you seen your youngest children?
No, I haven't, no. My little one was 4 months old when my sight went, and the other one was only a year old, so, yeah, I haven't seen their faces at all. Yeah, it's been really, really emotional. I get really angry with myself, really, because I want to do things with them that every other person could do. Yeah, it's very hard.
So you went into evening prayers yesterday. What happened in evening prayers?
We just really wanted to go in there before we left to go to the camp. And just sort of sat in there and just felt at peace, really. And they just sort of started praying and then they went into the healing prayer. And
so this is, Lord, wherever spiritual darkness touches my life.
Yes.
I trust you to lighten it.
Yes. And they prayed and carried on praying and praying. And then they asked people for healing and a lot of people stood up. But I didn't stand up because Sylvia was praying for me beside me. And then I just fell to my knees and they carried on praying. And
did you have pain in your eyes?
Yes, I did, yes. I just fell to my knees and then just fell even further.
Just crying,
and just really, really crying. And they just, I don't know how many people were praying, but they were all praying.
There was a lot of praying.
And then they carried on praying and praying and praying. Then I finally sort of sat up and then they still carried on praying. And then I opened my eyes and I said to the gentleman opposite that I liked his T-shirt.
Amazing. Absolutely amazing.
It's made, yeah, just everybody was dancing. Sylvia was dancing and crying, and yeah, it's just amazing.
And when you turned and looked at your husband, what did you see?
Oh, I could see his great big grin on his face, a great big smile on his face. He was shining from ear to ear, and he hasn't stopped since.
So you're going to go home and you're going to see children that you've not seen for 8 years, yes, or you've never seen.
It's just going to be amazing, but we're going to go and see our pastor first. and then we're going to go and get our children.
And I noticed when I came in and met you that you were just constantly looking out the different windows and looking at everything. And
it is just amazing, it's beautiful, and I just don't want to leave now because I just can see everything. It's just wonderful.
So what do you think of a Lord who loves you so much that he would...
He's fantastic, and I just want to celebrate, and I want to go on my knees, but I just can't keep still at the moment.
So your dark glasses are discarded, and the white stick is about to be abandoned.
Yes. It's going in the bin.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
God is good.
All the time. Yeah.